cry. Thank you. I don't know what your 19-year-old is doing, but I know what those two do. So thank you for being here. For those of you that I don't know, I am Reverend Judy-Ann Davis Young, as I affectionately say, Miss Bertha's baby girl. And I say that to pay homage to a woman that made me the woman that I am today. So welcome, welcome, welcome. We are in for some fun today. Excuse me. Do you have the time? How many of you remember 20 years ago when everyone had a wristwatch? Oh, yeah, back in the day. As they say, way back in the day. And you could always tell people they had good watches because you'd ask, excuse me, do you have the time? And they had this way of doing so you could make sure you had a good look at that Rolex. And they would tell the time and until you would say, oh, is that a Rolex? Oh, it just happens to be one. But now that we have cell phones, we're caught up in a different kind of era. We don't ask anyone what time it is because we all have cell phones. But I'm going to ask you today, excuse me, what time is it? I was thinking the other day, and I do this sometime, every now and then, you know, everywhere you turn, there's this fight for equality. There's fight for gender equality, marriage equality, health equality. All the poor need help. There is even tax equality. The rich don't want to pay too much. The poor say they pay it way too much. There's this whole thing around equality. And it seems to be a theme everywhere you look. Everybody wants to make sure they get their fair share. Well, this is what I was thinking. There's one place where everyone in this room, everyone on this planet is equal. And it's in time. The rich don't get any more minutes in their day than you and I get. The GED and the PhD get the same 1,440 minutes in a 24-hour period. Be you Baptist, Catholic, New Thought, Hindu, Muslim, you still are only going to get 24 hours in a day. It doesn't matter how rich you are. It doesn't matter whether you're black, white, Polish, Italian, Alaska native. It doesn't matter. We're all equal when it gets to time. And it's one of the few places that equality exists for everyone. You all agree? Okay, now that we have some agreement, that the time, so what is the difference? If Oprah and Jay Leno and Britney Spears, they don't get any more time than we do. It's all about how we're using our time. Now, what I can tell you is we are eternally creating. Every single day, we start anew. We are not bound by any past experience. I don't care what happened to you last year, what happened to you in the last hour. It really doesn't matter right now because day by day, minute by minute, hour by hour, all any of us has is the now. So what time do you have? You have now. You have now to be all that you came here to be. It's not predicated on any conversation. It's not predicated on what your mother did, what your daddy didn't do, where you grew up, how much money you have. That's history. Yes, we go back and look at it, but we shouldn't be married to it. So when I look at, if that's the truth, then I have to ask myself some questions about this thing called time. What I get out of my time is based on three things: my intention, my focus, and my alignment with God's highest vision of itself as me. You go to the bank with that. That's good. What is your intention for this day, for this now moment? What are you focused on? And what is God's highest alignment as itself for you? It doesn't get any easier than that. Now, what I can tell you is God has big ideas for each one of us. See, God's idea of us is what I call a big idea. You all know what a big gulp is? Oh, God's idea of me is a big idea. God's idea of each one of us is a big idea. Well, what's stopping us from getting there? You can have the intention and you can have the focus. But if you're not aligned. Now, I'm going to go into something that talks about alignment. We're going to get to your intention and your focus because they're well needed. But this alignment is some critical stuff. Because alignment is based on the vehicle you're driving. That's you. You all drove cars to get here, most of us did. Have you ever noticed that when you're driving your car and you're just riding around in the city, things look pretty good and you say, well, you know, something is wrong with the car. And you take it to the mechanic and he says, well, let me take it out for a test drive and get it up to speed. This is what happens with us in life. We can mosey along, but when we start trying to get up to speed, oh, some things gonna pop off. Oh, it's going to show up. Just like the alignment in your car. You can ride around from stoplight to stoplight, you don't feel anything, but you get up to 65 miles an hour, it starts shaking, rattling, and rolling. And if your tires are out of alignment, you're going to know it because everything that needs to be corrected is going to show up as soon as you get up to speed. It's the same thing as the vehicle as me. The things I need to correct, I can cruise around day to day, la, la, la. But when I try to have God's big idea of me, oh, and I try to get up to speed, if I'm not in alignment, the places where I'm not, it's going to start to shake, rattle, and roll. Now, what is alignment? You have four tires on your car. You have four things that help bring you into alignment. They are faith, trust, spiritual practice, and love. Now, we've all been driving long enough to know that when one of your tires goes flat, it doesn't take you long to figure out which one it is. Life, that vehicle as you, kind of like the same thing. You get out of alignment and you realize that you haven't been going within. You haven't been expressing gratitude. You haven't been praying. You haven't been just being all that you came here to be at the core of who you are. And you start to notice. And that's when you start to ramp back and say, you question yourself, am I good enough to do this? Do I have what it takes? No, what it means in reality is you need to put some air in your tire. You need to go somewhere and get stoked up. And then you fall back into the silence and get quiet. And I'm going to invite you to do something because when we're trying to get up to speed, to be all that we came here, like I said, all the things that could are going to pop up because you're only going to notice it when you're moving fast, when you're trying to get to what they call the sweet spot. The sweet spot. Does anyone know what the sweet spot is? Okay. For those of you that don't know, I'm an avid motorcycle rider. And athletes have it, motorcyclists have it, dancers have it. And the sweet spot is when your confidence, your competence, and your clarity all come together and you just roll it. And it's smooth. You almost feel like you're sitting still. It gets so good to you. You're on a roll. That's the sweet spot. That's what we strive for in life. That spot where our love, our affairs, our finance, our dreams, all of it's happening, is cracking all at the same time. That's the sweet spot in life. Well, as you're climbing up to that and you hit that wobble in your tires, your faith and your trust start to waver, go within. Some people think it takes a lot of time to go back to the now. It's just a matter of moments. I can look around and tell when people start to drift. Like, where are we going with this? What do we got to do? Come on now, I got somewhere to go. I'm going to invite you to go on a journey with me. When you get to that point where you start to doubt what you experience, where you start to question, am I good enough? Will I ever find love? Will I ever achieve my dreams? Will I ever be in harmony with my family? That's the point where you drop back, do some corrective actions. And I'm going to ask everyone to go with me on this journey and put your hand on your heart. And this is the place where you get to go within. And when you have those moments that you begin to doubt, I want you to come right back here. As Mackenzie reminds us, we've never, nor will we ever, do it by ourselves. There's always someone there.
When I am down, and oh, my soul so weary, when troubles come, my heart burden be, then I am still and wait here in the silence until you come and sit a while with me. You raise me up so I can stand on me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong when I am on your shoulders. Raise me up to more than I can be.
Everybody just take this moment. Really take this moment and think about what makes you strong. What brings you to all you can be? Love, God, peace, it could be anything, but just know it. Shoulders raise me up to more. You raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong when I am on your shoulders. Can be. You raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to more than I can be. I am strong when I am on your shoulders. Me up to more than I can be.
These children don't have me up here crying the ugly cry. But how many of you felt being raised up? That's God's idea of you. So let's talk about your intention. See, what is your intention for yourself? Back in the day before we had fancy computers, my mother would, the night before, sit with a pencil and a piece of paper, and she would make a to-do list of what she wanted to do the next day. And Colleen talked about visioning. And visioning is a wonderful way to get clarity on what God's big idea of your life is. You will be surprised what happens when you go into the silence and you set the intention. You set the intention and you listen, not with these things out here. You listen with your inner ear to that voice that speaks to you and you say, what? That's the voice you're listening to. You see with the inner eye. We cannot. We've already demonstrated, each one of us, that we cannot rely on our own understanding. Because you know what? I can't believe everything my brain tells me. Because, you know, sometimes I see them huddling on the football field, and I think they're talking about me. So I know that I cannot be believing everything, and I invite you to do the same thing. When you see people standing around quietly and they stop talking and you walk up, does not mean they're talking about you. Yeah, I needed to put that out there, because sometimes folks just get way full. Oh, what makes you think that you're so important that I'm... My friend Leslie comes up and she's telling me something going on with her, and she stops when you show up. She's not talking about that ugly green dress I have on. She's telling me something that's personal to her. So set your intention and listen with your inner ear. Because what I know is when you put your attention on your intention, you're not chasing anything. You're being pulled by your vision. It's calling you. You don't have to chase it. There's a huge difference in being pulled by a dream than to be chasing a dream. How many of us have those dreams as our intention? If you don't have a dream as your intention, I'm going to tell you something. You're not living God's big idea of you. Everyone that is here for a reason and for a purpose. God didn't just need to have a whole bunch of folks walking around, polluting the earth. We are here for a divine purpose. So when you tap into that intention and it starts pulling you and you start seeing your dream formulating and materializing in front of you, you know that you're listening with the inner ear. And I'm going to speak specifically to people over 50. Because if you listen at a lot of things going on in our culture, it'll tell you that you shouldn't have any dreams. Let me tell you something. There's two things I know don't have an expiration date, and I got and like both of them. Dreams do not have an expiration date, and neither do money. I've never met any money soul I couldn't spend it. I'm just saying. And this is what I know emphatically. When you set your intention, stay in the what and get out of the how. See, we become afraid and we talk ourselves out of stuff. Well, how am I going to do it? Don't worry about it. Set the intention and focus on that. Stay out of the how. Let God worry about how. Oh, I didn't know how I was going to get all of this chocolate thunder sitting on the front row. But God did. I didn't know that. I didn't need to know it. I didn't know how I would ever be a minister. It was the furthest thing from my dreams. God knew. All I had to do was be obedient and focus. This is it. I'm going to wrap it up with this about focus. This is critical also. What you focus on most of the time is what you're going to see in your life. Ooh. Catch your mind. I invite all of you to do something that I have done. Set your alarm on your cell phone to go off randomly every day, 4 or 5 times a day, and watch your thoughts. When it go off, just say, oh. And you'll be surprised at the things that gallop through your mind. And you'll be saying, where'd that come from? Oh, my God. Focus and watch your thoughts. Be a good steward of what you're thinking. Some people want to fight with their thoughts. This is what I can tell you. You don't have to try to control all your thoughts. Just don't let your thoughts control you. See, that's the secret. Oh, it's okay to have the fear, do it anyway. It's okay to feel that alone moment and know that you're being raised up. And it's okay to go through all of those range of emotions and know that they're just your ego fighting because you're living up to God's big idea as you. I'm going to bring this to an end and share with you, when you think of excuse me, do you have the time? The time is now. And every day you can reset the clock. However ugly the last hour is, you just stop. 1 minute is all you have to give yourself to go within and be quiet. And ask the question, God, what is the lesson in this for me today, right now? 1 minute out of 1,440 minutes in a 24-hour period, all you need is 1 minute to go in, align yourself with God's highest vision of you, focus on what it is you say you want and not what you don't want, and remember what your intention is. God didn't just put you here to be a placeholder. You came with a divine appointment. It's up to you to keep it. I'm Miss Bertha's baby girl. Namaste. This is the time in our service when I invite our prayer minister.